Anti-polygamy is anti-woman, anti-constitution, anti-Bible, and anti-Semitic. That's right. I knew I'd get your attention. Tomorrow, when someone asks you, why did you vote yes to repeal anti-polygamy laws for consenting adults? You will confidently and quickly and easily say, you did it because you know that women are not stupid. Women are not weak. They're not feeble-minded. They're not incapable of asserting their equality in a relationship. And the minute that guy thinks he's going to be an idiot, they will gang up on him. Hello? Women are not stupid. But anti-polygamy requires you to think that women are, and they aren't. Think about that for a minute. Let's introduce you to Moses and his wife, Zipporah, and the Ethiopian wife. And the law wants to say, Moses, you have to go to jail because of a story, Adam and Eve, that you wrote. The 10th Amendment prohibits federal government involvement in any form of marriage. And the Supreme Court has actually had four recent Supreme Court cases that can overturn anti-polygamy laws. Now, on the right, your values of the Bible and limited government compel you to vote yes. Now, on the left, your values of tolerance and equality for all. Tolerance automatically requires you to tolerate uncoerced, freely consenting adults choosing polygamy. End of story from Tolerance Dogma. Now, let's get an understanding of this. This is about woman's choice. Now, for those of you guys who think you're going to be the best men, get it easy! Get ready for double honeydews. So I urge you to vote yes to stop criminalizing women choosing the best men, so that the phrase, all the best men are taken, no longer applies. The free marriage market, let women have a choice. Let them choose the best and incentivize the rest.